clarification, one point, sir. The Honorable Minister has pointed out there are some power plants which have come up without a PPA being signed and
coal
without
coal linkage.
Without any coal linkage. Sir, would he please ask the bankers who have financed these power plants without a coal linkage and without a PPA?
Honorable Deputy Chairman, it's a very good question. I'm very happy that it has been asked. Of course, all these power plants were financed in the last 10 years when I was sitting on, of which 4 years I was sitting.
So you have no contribution to that.
But the Honorable MP was sitting on this side of the House.
A very conflicting remark and a very confusing remark that power plants have come up duly financed by the banks without a PPA linkage and without coal linkage and without PPA being signed.
Sir,
you must clarify that.
Sir, many of these power plants have also come up on the back of coal block allocations which have been found to be irregular by the Honorable CAG, and many of them have got into trouble because the process which was followed by the erstwhile government caused agony to the entire coal sector, which the nation is suffering from today. And I think it would be very interesting if the Honorable MP would reflect on whether it was the right method of giving coal blocks and making private sector and government companies set up power plants on the back of those irregular allotments. And it may be very interesting also to see how those banks, in that regime, was there any pressure from the then government to those bankers to give those loans? It will be a matter of investigation. I will be delighted to have an investigation done on that. But I'm not sure the Honorable MP will be very happy with the findings.